Welcome to the Dynamics Tutorials. So with this problem, we have the same curve that we did a couple problems back. We have y is equal to 2 times the square root of x, but this problem's set up a little differently and we'll have to use a different method to solve it. So with this problem, we know that the velocity is 10 meters per second, and this is the total speed. This is not just the x or the y component, but the total speed. And that the speed is increasing at a rate of 2 meters per second squared. And this is happening when x is at 2 meters. So we don't have really any information about just the x or the y component of the velocity, but we can go ahead and apply normal and tangential coordinates on this one and solve it fairly easily from what we're given. And we're just trying to find the magnitude of the acceleration. So for our first step is going to be to calculate the radius of curvature. So we're going to calculate our first derivative of our function with respect to x. So it'll be x to the 1/2 times 2. So the 1/2 will move out in front. So it'll be 2 divided by 2 will give us 1. And that'll be x to the negative 1/2. We'll plug in x is equal to 2 and get 0.7071. Remember that the first derivative is going to be unitless because it's how are you changing y when you change x, so you have length over length, so the units cancel out here. Doing our second derivative, we'll take the negative 1/2 and move it out in front, and then we'll have x to the negative 3/2. We'll plug in x is equal to 2 meters and get negative 0.1768. And then our units now are going to be 1 over meters. We're taking a derivative of this with respect to x. So in effect, we're dividing this by another length unit. So 1 over the length unit there. And then we'll plug this into the radius of curvature function. So the radius of curvature is 1 plus the first derivative squared, this whole top part raised to the 3/2 power, divided by the absolute value of the second derivative. So plugging in the numbers here gives us a radius of curvature of 10.39. Also, you might want to take a look at an online math program like Wolfram Alpha. You can literally just type in radius of curvature of, give it the function, say at x is equal to 2, and it'll go through and calculate that radius of curvature if you ever want to double check when you're doing a homework problem, if you're not for sure if you calculated the radius of curvature correctly. Obviously, you'd want to be able to calculate the radius of curvature on your own, just with your calculator, if you're practicing for a test, though, right? And then your tangential acceleration is just going to be your first derivative of your speed, so your first derivative of your scalar velocity. We know that our scalar velocity is increasing at 2 meters per second squared, so that's our tangential acceleration. And then our normal acceleration is going to be equal to v squared divided by the radius of curvature. So we plug in our 10 meters per sec, and we plug in our radius of curvature, we get 9.62 meters per second squared. So we can calculate the magnitude of our acceleration here, just by taking both components, squaring them, adding them together, taking a square root. And when we do that, we get that our total acceleration is 9.83 meters per second squared. Thanks for watching.